Good morning and welcome to Murlocs Invade Naxxramas. This is Doc Stout, coming back to challenge once again Frostworm Lair. Yesterday, if you tuned in, you saw that I was struggling a little bit. And I don't know that I've got any real fixes on Saffron.
My massive Frostworm awaits! Dress warm.
The biggest issue with Saffron is his hero ability. You can destroy every turn all enemy minions that aren't frozen. Now, they provide you with a frozen block of ice minion that makes the guys on either side of it immune. The problem with this is the deck doesn't just do that. It plays all the normal removal, board wipes, direct damage, and taunters that usually I have to overcome with my Murloc decks by sheer weight of numbers. Problem is Saffron's hero ability makes sheer weight of numbers not really a thing. So I think I'm going to need to sculpt a perfect hand with the current deck to take him down. Let's give it a shot. This is not the first normal mode boss that I've struggled with a lot, persisting in beating all the bosses with Warlock Murloc.
Gul'dan versus Saffron!
Your soul shall be mine!
Cold Lightseer does not seem to be helpful. So we'll try with a Lepronome, an Iron Beak Owl, and a Soulfire.
Look at that little gnome. He used to be an interloper like yourself.
Frozen Champion and the Leper Gnome. Tidehunter seems to be almost exactly right. Make him burn through his hand, yeah. Okay, now I'm really glad I held onto the Iron Beak Owl. We'll just silence the taunt there and actually get in for some damage. I think I'll just pass turn here. Now the shame here is he had the ability to kill all my guys, but the Murloc Tidehunter is going to put its scout on the same side of the ice block. It's not very useful. Meaning I probably want to save him. He can just get bigger and bigger and bigger. Which means I think I'm just going to take care of him right now with Shadow.
Stop hiding behind that block of ice!
Join me in death.
Get a couple of Murlocs here. Pump him up as big as I can. He's gonna get killed by the Necronite anyway. Oh, I love how that happens. That kind of sucks. Okay, so note for next time. Tidecaller's on the left. Tidehunter's on the right.
Thumbs.
Guess we'll go like this, because he's gonna die anyway. Oh yeah. Huh. I didn't think that one all the way through.
Oh.
probably should have soul fired the Necronite.
Job's done.
Game is a lot harder if you make mistakes. Now I don't have Hellfire to deal with that. Okay, I pretty much need to kill him here or wipe the board. Still die if I don't come up with something. Looks like I die anyway. Strike there. And still take 4.
Put this apple on your head.
Yeah. That doesn't actually do anything. And yet another mistake, not that it matters. Alright, first attempt did not go so well. Everything is difficult as I remember it, compounded by my own mistakes. Alright, if you were just joining us, I am Doc Stout with Murlocs Invade Naxxramas. Going to continue to work on Saffron, who's been blowing me out with a combination of Frost Breath, Removal, and Taunters. Don't know how many attempts I'll get in today before Gouda I conclude this is unwinnable Saffron without a deck reconstruction.
Your soul shall be mine!
Like a war leader. Knife juggler, not so much. Let's see if we can get something better. Eh. Certainly Grimmscale Oracle is better with a taunter than without.
Why do you call?
I'm gonna start with a taunter. No. Start with one. I guess I'll just play a threat. Sort of. Death Rattle. This Death Rattle only does one. Let's try and get in for some damage. That's not too bad. Bluegill Warrior will get charged and he'll get both of the buffs. Let's get in as much damage as I can. I think I gotta take that.
Stop hiding behind that block
19.
Of ice! Noxrax is ours.
None of my cards do anything. So we swing as hard as we can. Do this. Tide Caller here. Tide Hunter here. And then power overwhelming the only guy who can attack. Six. Need to dig. Get in for three. And then actually play the leper gnome. Force him down to one life when he breathes. Made a mistake. It looks like I just won. If he just attacked my Murloc Tidecaller, I would have had to dig for another answer, but as it stands, he's at one. Thanks to the trigger up. And Saffron is down. Not gonna lie.
Dragon! I do not like you.
I was thinking I was going to be spending the entire morning throwing attempts into this guy. I believe that was a combination of the perfect cards, just some lucky mistakes by the AI, and actually remembering the lessons we learned from the last few attempts. Feeding Saffron, we get an Echoing Ooze. We've seen a lot of this in these videos. It's a 1-2 for 2 that copies himself as a battle cry at the end of the turn. What's interesting is he copies himself as well as whatever effects you've applied to him. So if you've given him a bunch of buffs, given him taunt, the copy will have all those things as well. Well, we are down to the last boss. As far as I know, there's a Kel'Thuzad himself. Join me tomorrow for the attempt at the end of this invasion. I'd like to thank you for joining. Was a pretty successful run, I'd say. Tomorrow, the Murlocs will hopefully complete their invasion of Anaxtramas. Thanks for watching. This is Doc Stout, signing out. Murgle on, my friends.